Hello friends, welcome back to another episode by Engineering Today, and hope you're all having a great time. Activities at SpaceX's Starbase facility in Boca Chica, Texas, have been a subject of great intrigue and anticipation within the space community. A series of recent developments, including the removal of the Hot Staging Ring, HSR, from Booster 9, or B9, have left enthusiasts and experts speculating about the company's ambitious plans. The removal of the hot staging ring from Booster 9 marks a significant event, raising numerous questions about the purpose behind this operation. While SpaceX has not officially disclosed the exact reason behind this maneuver, the prevailing speculation is that it was done to gain access to the top of the booster. This has led some to wonder if SpaceX is making modifications or conducting inspections related to its ongoing Starship development program. The unexpected destacking of Ship 25, just days before the removal of the HSR from Booster 9, added to the air of uncertainty and excitement around the Starbase facility. These actions seem to suggest that SpaceX is meticulously scrutinizing every aspect of its hardware as it strives for perfection in its pursuit of space exploration. The use of the Marvin crane and lifting jig for these operations demonstrates SpaceX's commitment to safety and precision. While the recent activities at the Starbase facility might raise eyebrows and spark curiosity, they should also be seen as a testament to SpaceX's dedication to achieving groundbreaking milestones in space travel. As with any complex engineering project, setbacks and adjustments are part of the journey, and patience is required to reach the ultimate goal. Booster 10, the upcoming flight booster in the queue, recently underwent cryogenic proof testing at Massey's testing facility. Simultaneously, Booster 13 was being assembled in the Mega Bay, and work on the Orbital Launch Mount, or OLM, continued as planned. At Massey's, the cryogenic proof testing focused on the liquid oxygen, or LOX, tank of Booster 10, subjecting it to extreme cold conditions with loads of liquid nitrogen, LN2. Following the successful cryo test, Booster 10 commenced its journey from Massey's test site back to Mega Bay 1, located at the build site. This relocation likely signifies the beginning of engine installation and additional modifications to prepare Booster 10 for flight. These upgrades are essential for its readiness to embark on a static fire campaign on the OLM. Apart from hot staging, this time Starship is going to have lots of changes. The booster's engines now feature electric thrust vector control, a departure from the previous hydraulic system. This change simplifies engine movement and eliminates the need for hydraulic power units, HPUs. Additionally, it allows for faster engine startup at liftoff. To prevent engine damage during flight, SpaceX has reinforced the shielding between the engines on the booster. These upgrades aim to prevent engine failures and protect neighboring engines. Following a fire during the first flight, SpaceX has substantially increased the fire suppression system's capacity on the booster. This system now features larger tanks and vents to mitigate fires and protect the vehicle. SpaceX has added more charges to the flight termination system, FTS, on both the booster and the Starship itself. The FTS is crucial for ensuring the safe termination of the flight if necessary. The launch pad has also seen major upgrades, with the addition of a flame deflector to protect the concrete from engine exhaust. This new system ensures a stronger foundation and prevents the engines from digging into the ground. The launch pad has also undergone adjustments to accommodate changes in the vehicle's height and features a protective cover for the ship's quick disconnect umbilical. SpaceX has introduced cryogenic pumps and subcoolers on the orbital tank farm to reduce propellant load times for future flights. It's worth noting that SpaceX's commitment to improvement doesn't stop with Flight 2. On the other hand, Blue Origin has been steadily progressing towards the highly anticipated maiden launch of its orbital class rocket, New Glenn. This ambitious project represents a significant milestone in Blue Origin's mission to make space more accessible, and recent developments indicate that they're getting closer to this goal. One of the most noteworthy developments in Blue Origin's New Glenn project is the submission of plans for a refurbishment facility near the Cape Canaveral skid strip. This facility, spanning 58.8 acres, is designed to serve as a hub for refurbishing launch vehicles and reusing various components for rocket launches. The proximity of this facility, just a short 2-kilometer drive from Launch Complex 36, LC-36, is strategic, as it streamlines the rocket refurbishment process and supports Blue Origin's mission to establish New Glenn as a reliable workhorse in the space industry, akin to SpaceX's Falcon rockets. In August, Blue Origin provided a glimpse into its progress by releasing a photo of the inside of its primary production building at Exploration Park. The image revealed a vast array of hardware, including first and second stage tank sections, barrel sections, domes, engine and landing leg sections, and interstage. This visual insight into their production process demonstrated the substantial progress made on New Glenn's construction. Moreover, Blue Origin unveiled a video on its website dedicated to the New Glenn project, showcasing a first stage tank inside the tank cleaning and testing facility, located adjacent to the primary production building. This video offered a behind-the-scenes look at the meticulous testing and preparation involved in the New Glenn project. As Blue Origin ramps up production, it's also actively preparing LC-36 to support hardware testing for New Glenn. Recent months have witnessed a series of tests involving both the main transporter erector, intended for supporting a fully assembled New Glenn, and a smaller transporter erector, seemingly dedicated to testing New Glenn's second stage on the launch pad. Once positioned at the launch mount, the transporter erector is raised to a vertical position, mimicking the procedure that will be used for actual launches. In parallel with testing New Glenn's upper stages on the launch pad, Blue Origin has established a new test site east of the launch pad dedicated to first stage tank testing. Known as the GS-1 test area, Glenn Stage 1, this facility has been equipped with stands for testing rocket stages and propellant lines running from the launch pad to the test stand. In early August, Blue Origin conducted a test fire of the BE-3U engine at Marshall Space Flight Center's test stand 4670. This test marked a significant milestone, as Blue Origin had recently upgraded the historic test stand to accommodate both BE-3U and BE-4 engines, which are vital components for New Glenn. A video released by Blue Origin showcased both BE-3U and BE-4 engines on the test stand simultaneously, emphasizing the company's commitment to rigorous testing and innovation. As Blue Origin continues on its journey to make space more accessible, the world watches with anticipation for the moment when New Glenn takes flight, marking another significant milestone in the commercial space industry. But believe it or not, the star of the show is definitely going to be SpaceX's Starship. What do you think? Put down your thoughts in the comments below to start a healthy discussion. And that's all for now. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.